Welcome to another episode of MacBreak Studio. We're looking at Final Cut Pro and doing some bling to titles.
We're adding some bling to our 3D titles.
Yeah,
we're taking them a little bit further.
Can you add bling to 2D titles?
You can add bling to anything you want because we have a free plugin
called Bling.
Well, it's not called Bling, but it does the bling thing.
Awesome.
So, yeah, so let's dive in and take a look. So here I'm in Final Cut Pro, and right now I'm looking at the titles browser and the built-in 3D titles that ship with Final Cut Pro 10.2. And you can apply our new plugin to any 3D title or any title or anything you want, but it works really great on 3D text. But I'm not going to do that. I'm just showing you that they're there. I'm actually going to go down to Ripple 3D animations, Ripple 3D title animations, because these are some kind of supercharged 3D titles.
That they have a lot more parameters that publish.
Yeah. And the reason I'm using them, we'll find out in just a minute. But if you look in your own browser and you don't see them and you want to know, well, where can I get these? They're free. And all you need to do is download FX Factory, which is a plugin management application. You download FX Factory, and in the catalog, you'll see right here Ripple 3D title animations. They're free, and you just download them and go at it, use them. So I'm going to take the one called Super Rotate and add it to my timeline.
By the way, Super Rotate's a really good title to put bling on because as the text rotates, you'll be able to see the.
Yeah, exactly. So by default, it's a nice little animation. And I'll go to the inspector here. I'm not going to change much in here. We've talked about these in another MacBreak Studio. I'll just choose Tumble Characters to change the animation a little bit. But now what I want to do is basically add a light pass, add a glow to these that looks really nice.
You can just leave the material the way it is.
Yeah. And what I'm going to do is built into Motion is a new filter called Glint.
It's actually 5.2 it showed up?
In 5.2 it showed up, and it works great on 3D text. It's not available in Final Cut Pro, so what we've done is just made it so you can use it in Final Cut Pro.
All right.
Very simple, and it's free, and the place that you get it is a little bit different because it's not part of FX Factory. It's actually, you get it from the Ripple Training website. So I'm going to show you here Ripple Training. You go to rippletraining.com, you click on the plugin section at the very top up here, and then you scroll down past our other plugins, and you'll see our free plugins.
It's a lot of free plugins there.
Yeah, and we've got more coming, so there'll probably be more there by the time you watch this. So there's the free 3D Ripple RT Glint.
RT for okay. Ripple Training.
So that's where you get both of those, okay? So now I've got Super Rotate. I'm going to go to the Effects Browser to the Custom category, and there's RT Glint. And I'm going to throw it onto this 3D text.
Text that's now electrified.
Yeah, and now it's kind of crazy by default, depending on what your material is and depending on what your environment is. So you may have a very different result depending on what you've done to your text. I did nothing. I've just got the default
plastic
material.
Text.
Yeah, with the default environment, default font, everything. So what I'm going to do is go to the video inspector because that's where our effects live. And there's RT Glint. I'm going to pull the exposure down so it's not quite so intense. And I'm really not going to do anything else. There's a lot of great parameters here, but I mostly want to focus on two ideas. The first is that once you apply it, if your text moves and rotates at all, hit the /// key to play this clip.
Ooh, you see the glint.
Yeah, by the rotating, you actually see that glint kind of come on and off by itself, and it looks beautiful.
It does. You didn't do anything, and you see a nice glint.
Yeah, it's kind of very, very little work, and I can take it much further, but we'll stop right there. And the other thing I can do is, well, I'd like to see the glint move across the text while it's sitting still.
Sure.
In fact, I can choose for this title, I'll go back to the title inspector now for this title, and I'm going to take the animation style and set it to none. So it's just there. It fades up and it's there. Okay? But I want it to fade up and then I want a nice light pass across it to happen. Like, well, how do you do that? Well, with the built-in titles, you can't. Do what I'm about to do, and that's why I'm using our free titles here, because with ours, if we now go to the bottom of the title inspector, there's a parameter, a published parameter called environmental rotation, which will take the virtual sphere that this text lives in, that its light is being reflected off this text, and rotate it. So I'm going to scrub in the Y value field.
Well, I see. It's not like a light's passing. It's like you're moving the world around it.
Yeah, but it effectively makes it look like light is passing across
that text.
Of course,
it looks really great.
So I'm going to back up to right before that light pass starts, and I'll set a keyframe, and then I'll move to a little later in time, and I'm going to scrub to after that light pass goes through. So now if I play through that, I'll back up a little bit. I get a nice light pass that I can exactly control.
That's really nice.
Okay, so it makes it super easy to create a nice glowing light pass on your text. And then you could combine those. Now that I've done that, I could go back and turn the animation back on. Maybe I'll take something different, like Cascade is a nice animation, and play that. And the text comes on, we get a nice light pass, and it rotates out.
Nice.
Okay, so pretty fast and easy to create a nice light pass, glowing bling to your
text. And there's a lot of parameters in there. Notice you can change the color of the glint, you can change the thickness, the how many spikes. I mean, there's what's great about these plugins, you publish a lot of parameters, so you can really go in and play with them to make some stuff that really looks interesting.
And the trick is to go to all of these inspectors, because in the title inspector, we have the published parameters for this particular title. In the text inspector, we have all of the 3D controls. So for example, we could change the material in here to a metal.
Steel or something.
Like, what'd you say?
Like a steel or something.
Yeah, some kind of steel or a chrome or a nickel or something else.
That looks cool.
That looks really pretty, kind of blue. And then in the video inspector, we have our effect. So by default, we can add a tint. So instead of, it's already blue,
maybe a red tint.
Yeah. So now we see a nice red glow there. So that looks absolutely beautiful. So now
that's really cool.
We can get a whole different look very, very quickly. There, I like that better.
That's really fantastic.
Even better. And
that was just a few changes, too.
Yeah, just ran through a couple quick changes, and we've got a whole new look of some nice steel that fades in. And to me, this is movie, feature, film quality kind of titles that you can do very quickly with a free title and a free plugin in Final Cut Pro with the 3D text capabilities.
Excellent. So you want to check that out, check our site, check out our free plugins. And actually, there's more than just Glint. You can download them all. And you want to play with those. Thanks for watching Mac Break, and check us out on Twitter and Facebook, and check out all Mark's wonderful tutorials on our website. There's a lot of training there, and of course our YouTube videos. So thanks a lot for watching another episode of Mac Break Studio.